Let's study Poisueille's equation. When we talk about Poisueille's equation, this is basically concerned with the flow of a viscous fluid in a tube. Like if we talk about the flow of an ideal fluid in a tube of uniform cross section, we can say if the cross section is uniform, the flow velocity at the point where fluid is entering must be equal to the flow velocity with which it will come out according to continuity equation. And according to Bernoulli's theorem, if at this end pressure is P1, at the other end it is P2, we can write as the tube is horizontal and the flow velocity is same in the situation P1 is equals to P2. This is for the situation for an ideal fluid. But this is not the similar situation when a viscous fluid flows. If we talk about a viscous fluid which is flowing through a pipeline, and in the tube, if the flow velocity is V, here we can say the radius of tube is R, then the discharge rate of fluid can be written as Q, which is the product of cross-sectional area multiplied by the velocity, which is pi R square V. This is the discharge rate at which the fluid will discharge through the tube. In this situation, if this is end A, this is end B, and if pressure is PA and PB, in this situation, we can say obviously when the fluid is flowing, the fluid layers would be experiencing friction in backward direction due to viscous forces. So in this situation, PA has to be more than PB, without which the fluid won't flow, as we need some force to overcome the viscous force. Here we can say according to Poisueille's equation, the discharge rate of a viscous fluid through a tube can be given as, this given as Q is equals to pi r to power 4 by 8 eta L PA minus PB, that is the pressure difference, which is written as pi R to power 4 by 8 eta L, and the pressure difference across the tube. You just keep in mind this expression. Again, I am not going for the derivation of this expression, which is derived experimentally in a situation, as well as qualitatively we can understand. But you just need to keep this expression in mind. Directly, we are quoting this Poisueille's equation, which is giving us the discharge rate of a fluid across through a tube across which the pressure difference is delta P, and if the flow velocity is V, we can substitute Q as pi r square V, and we can find out the flow velocity also. Here eta is the viscous coefficient of fluid and L is the length of this tube through which the fluid is flowing. So for uniform steady flow, we need a pressure difference in case of a viscous fluid, whereas in case of ideal fluid, we have discussed no pressure difference is required to maintain the flow. And in viscous fluid, we require a pressure difference to maintain a steady flow of liquid.